This video explains how to set up tracking avoidance zones in your TracPhone system to mitigate the number one cause of service interruptions, blockage of the satellite signal. Satellites in a mini-VSAT broadband network are located over 35,000 kilometers or 22,000 miles above the equator. To communicate with the satellite, the antenna must point its reflector at its precise location in the sky, and it must remain locked on it as the vessel moves. Therefore, in an ideal installation, the antenna has an unobstructed view of the sky in all directions. Satellite signals cannot penetrate solid objects. Anything that stands between the antenna and the satellite can potentially block or degrade the signal and interrupt service. Common causes of blockage include mass, antennas, and other structures. RF energy emitted by a radar or high-power radio can also degrade the signal. With a tracking avoidance zone setup, you prevent the antenna from pointing toward a known obstruction that is likely to cause marginal reception and poor performance. Instead, the antenna quickly switches to a different satellite, provided an alternative is available in your region. To set up a tracking avoidance zone, you need to access the system's web interface. With a computer connected to the network, open your web browser and enter mini-vsat.kbh, or the ICM's IP address. At the web interface, go to the Settings tab and select Tracking Avoidance Zones. Next, click Edit and enter your administrator password. Now enter the azimuth range to avoid relative to the bow. The range must span at least 5 degrees. Then enter the elevation range. Keep in mind that the elevation angle to the satellite will fluctuate with pitch and roll, so negative elevations are possible. Next, enable the zone and click Save Settings. The zone is now set up. Let's run through some examples. This graph shows the relative strength of the satellite signal within the azimuth and elevation range of the antenna. You can clearly see something is interfering with the signal whenever the antenna points between 70 degrees and 125 degrees in azimuth. So we would set up a tracking avoidance zone to cover that area. Here's another example. This time, the obstruction is on the port side, between 250 and 270 degrees. Our tracking avoidance zone might look like this. Now consider this installation. We might want to set up two tracking avoidance zones, one for the radar and one for the spotlight. The lower height of the spotlight allows us to minimize that zone's elevation. The antenna can see over it. Once you've set up your zones, you have the option to change the time and zone setting. This is how long the antenna will be allowed to point within a zone while your vessel is turning. Based on the vessel's rate of turn, if the antenna will pass through a zone within the allotted time, it will stick with the current satellite. Before we close, please be aware that things outside the vessel can also interfere with satellite signals. For example, cranes at the dock, bridges, other vessels, and even severe weather. Although tracking avoidance zones can't possibly account for all cases of blockage, they can still make a huge difference in performance by avoiding the permanent blockage conditions on board that are most disruptive. But if there's too much blockage, you might consider moving the antenna to a better location. This concludes our video on tracking avoidance zones. To learn more, refer to the system's help. If you have any questions, please contact KVH Technical Support.